Today we're gonna manipulate this image with some light effects using the free Snapseed app. Before editing in Snapseed, I'm gonna first use the free tools in the Lightroom app to do some color tuning. This is mainly to separate the parts where the bright light will be added, especially on the greens here. Starting with some basic tuning in the light menu, where I'm gonna decrease highlights, increase the shadows to recover more details, tuning whites and blacks too with some added contrast. Little vibrance in color menu. Going to the HDR sliders, I'm gonna desaturate all colors other than the greens in the image. You may not notice, but there are some cyans in the trees. I'm gonna move the cyan hues more towards green and add more saturation. Similarly, adding saturation to the greens. This will help in getting desired results in Snapseed. I'm gonna save this image and import it to the Snapseed app. In Snapseed, first thing in Tune Image menu, I'm gonna increase the saturation to the maximum so that the greens further get saturated. Now for selective filters. Again, using them on the greens for more brightness and saturation. Now using more filters on the sky and the mountain to darken them as much as possible, also reducing the saturation. See the difference here? Now, moving to the black and white filter and choosing the green color option to make the greens the brightest. Notice the sky and the mountains are still a little bright, so adding a couple more selective filters to darken those spots. With the curves tool, I'm gonna add some hot contrast to make the green parts completely white. To remove the white spots in the foreground, turning the image completely to black by dragging the top point curve to the bottom. In the masking screen, applying the effect in the foreground. To get the orangish color, I'm gonna use curves again and drag the top point of the blue curve down, which adds yellows to the image. Also the greens, which adds magenta in combination, turns them to orange. Adding more brightness. Saving this, which will be later needed. Now I'm going to use the lens blur tool with linear mode selected. Increasing the blur strength here and saving this as a separate copy. My idea is to add a subtle lens flare effect. To do that, I'm going to use the perspective tool with the scale option selected. I'm going to horizontally drag on the image to stretch it. The more you repeat the same perspective effect, it turns into these lines. Here, repeating it about 8 times to get these orange lines. Saving this again. Now I'm going to start over by reverting the image to the starting point in Snapseed. Starting here with a couple of selective filters to brighten the reds and blues on the subject. Bit of masking work to remove the added effect in the surroundings. Now with curves, I'm going to darken the image. Also adding blue tones for that night effect. Next, with double exposure, I'm going to add the first saved image with the lighten mode selected, which works best here. Now adding the image of the blurred lights and selecting add mode. The effect can be too much, so reducing the opacity and going to the masking screen. Here I'm going to just tap on the lights to get the ambient light effect using the blurred image. Similarly, I'm going to add the image of the lines. Again, add mode selected, reducing the opacity. Applying it with masking. Going back to the curves effect where the image was darkened, in the masking screen, brushing out the darkness on the subject and little bit in the foreground. In tune image, adding more brightness and warmth. In the masking screen, again applying on and around the subject to get some light on the path. Using double exposure, I'm gonna now add an image of the night sky with the moon. Adjusting the opacity and in the masking screen, applying it on the sky. Taking a bit of time to get it right. Finally, with curves, adding some reddish tones to the highlights to make the bright lights further orangish. The final look here. Hope you found some useful tricks to enhance your images. Thanks for watching.